Greetings of the day. In today's video of business finance, we will start with the another type of question related to the leverages. In the earlier videos, we have seen how we can calculate leverages as the different information was given or provided in the question. In today's question, the things are a bit different, as we can say. We can see in the question which is attached in the link that in the earlier videos or earlier lectures we have seen that usually we have been provided with the information related to the statement of income, and we are required to calculate what we can say operating leverage, financial leverage and combined leverage. But in this particular question, what we can see that we have been provided with operating leverage of 2:1, financial leverage again 2:1, variable interest 10 lakh, tax rate 50% and variable cost 60% of the sales. And question says that we are required to prepare statement of income. That is why we have to solve the question in a different manner, as the credentials which are required for preparing the statement of income are not available with us. We need to calculate it. So we will start the solution with the help of financial leverage, as it would help us to calculate the answers of different things. What was the formula for financial leverage? We use the formula EBIT divided by EBT. EBIT divided by EBT. When we were preparing statement of income, what we have seen, whenever we deduct interest from EBIT, we get our EBT. That is why we can also write it like this: EBIT divided by EBIT minus interest. As we were deducting interest from EBIT, we would get EBT. So I have just replaced this EBIT by EBIT minus interest. We can see that mathematically it is definitely possible. So we would use this formula for the purpose of knowing the factors which are absent in this particular thing. So financial leverage given in the question is, what we can say, 2:1 is equals to EBIT, not known to us, humko pata nahi hai kya EBIT. So EBIT minus interest provided in the question. That is why we have used this formula, as we would need at least one thing which is known to us apart from financial leverage. Now I feel we are able to calculate EBIT, so we would just do the cross multiplication here, as we were doing in the mathematics in the schools. So we would do the same thing twice in bracket EBIT minus 10 lakh is equals to EBIT there would be cross multiplication. This EBIT minus interest, that is 10 lakh, would go here in the numerator side, whereas EBIT 1 would be multiplied by EBIT. Therefore EBIT multiplied by 1 would be EBIT only. So what we get, twice EBIT minus 20 lakh, as we have multiplied it by 22, is equals to EBIT. Now we will move this EBIT here and this 20 lakh there. Therefore twice EBIT, this positive EBIT would turn negative, is equals to minus 20 lakh would be now plus 20 lakh. Therefore EBIT is equals to 20 lakh. This is what we have done. What we have done, we have used the formula of financial leverage. What was the formula? EBIT divided by EBT. What was the formula for EBT? We have seen that EBIT minus interest is equals to EBT. That is what we have done in the formula. We have made an alteration. We have expanded the formula of EBT. EBT, what we have written, EBIT minus interest. That is what we have written. Now we have put the values in the question. What were the values? Financial leverage given 2:1, we have put it. EBIT not known to us, hence it is remained as it is. Again EBIT not known to us, we have kept it Likewise, whereas I interest is given of rupees 10 lakh, we have put the value of 10 lakh. Then we have simplified the formula. We have done the cross multiplication. 2 multiplied by EBIT minus 10 lakh bracket whole bracket close is equals to EBIT. Twice EBIT minus 20 lakh is equals to EBT. Therefore, we have shifted the terms. We have get both like terms on one side and alike terms on the second side. So EBIT was shifted. Twice EBIT minus EBIT is equals to 20 lakh. Therefore, EBIT is equals to 20 lakh. Here we know what is EBIT. Now we will use the operating leverage for the purpose of further calculation. What was the formula for operating leverage? We have used the formula of contribution divided by EBIT. Now we are knowing operating leverage, that is given in the question of 2:1. Contribution not known to us, but we have calculated the EBIT of rupees, what we can say, 20 lakh. We can use this thing for the purpose of calculation of contribution. Hence we will put the values in the formula. Operating leverage 2:1 is equals to contribution not known to us till now. Hence we would write it as contribution divided by EBIT. We have calculated in the first part, that is 20 lakh. We would put the value of 20 lakh. And now again, what we have done in this step, we will do that in the same step. We will cross multiply each thing. 2 multiplied by 20 lakh is equals to contribution. Therefore, contribution is equals to 40 lakh. Now we have just put the values and calculated the answer by using mathematical technique. Operating leverage, we are knowing to it, that is 2:1. Contribution unknown, that is why it remains stagnant. Whereas EBIT, we have calculated 20 lakh, we have put the values, we have cross multiply and simplify the equation. 2 into 20 lakh, that is cross multiplication of the both, is equals to 1 into contribution, that is contribution. Therefore contribution is of rupees 40 lakh. Now what things we are knowing? First of all, we have interest with us. Second thing, we have contribution with us. Third thing, we have EBIT with us. Now again, we would need one thing, that is variable expenses, so that we can calculate sales. That is the third part. Now we would calculate sales. Write down sales is equals to, what would be the sum up of sales? We can say that variable expenses plus contribution. Whenever we have contribution and variable expenses, it would accumulate as sales. Here we can see that we have been given variable expenses as 60% plus contribution, that would be the remaining portion, 100%. It means that sales, if variable expenses are 60%, then contribution would be 40%, that would be 100%. That is what we are doing here. Whenever we consider sale as 100, out of that 100, it is been mentioned in the question that 60% are variable expenses. That automatically means that 40% is our contribution in sales. That is what we have wrote. Now what we can do, we can just again use this thing. We can put in the bracket so that we could have understanding. 100% out of 100%, 60% were variable expenses and rest 40% are what we can say contribution. Again, the problem is that we are not knowing sales, again we are not knowing variable expenses, but still we have our contribution. So we can use this technique for the purpose of calculation of contribution. What we can do, we can say that variable contribution is of rupees 40 lakh. Hence we can write it like this. Sales is equals to what we are going to do, I am just telling you in short in working notes. When our contribution was 40%, I would just rub it and write it in the percentage form. When our contribution was 40%, then in rupees it was 40 lakh. So what it would be at the 100th level, that is what we have to do. We have to just cross multiply so that we can obtain our answer. So what we would do, 40 lakh into 100 divided by 40. This is what we are going to do so that we could obtain our answer. And same thing I would write it directly, that is 40 lakh multiplied by 100 divided by 40. This is what we have done. We usually use this technique in the statistics also for the or mathematics also. Ki jab contribution 40% pe 40 lakh 100% pe kitna rahega, that is what we have got. At the 40% level contribution is of 40 lakh, so at 100% what it would be. So just use the calculator and you will get your answer as rupees 1 crore. As rupees 1 crore. That is what is our answer. That is what how we are going to calculate the sales. What we have done here, we have to just have a quick reminder for it. Sales is equals to variable cost plus contribution. That is what is sales is. Here, what we have done, we have said that when say, we assume sale as a 100%, so at that point of time, variable cost is 60% and contribution is 40%. Therefore, at 40% level, when the contribution is 40 lakh, so at 100% level, what it would be? That is what we have wrote it here. Now, we will prepare statement of income. Statement of income, that is what the final requirement of the question is. Statement of income. We usually are having the format of statement of income, that is, first of all, we will write sales. We have calculated it for rupees 1 crore. Then variable cost. Then variable cost, we are not knowing it. But sales minus variable cost is EBIT. We have calculated EBIT. Sales minus variable cost is equals to contribution. We have calculated the part of contribution as of rupees 40 lakh. In here we have calculated contribution, sales was calculated in years. I would write it again so that you could see it properly and remember it where we have, from where we have taken the values. So we have contribution, we have sales. Definitely we can calculate variable cost by having the difference between both the amounts, that is 1 crore minus 40 lakh, that would be our variable cost. Now from contribution we have to deduct fixed cost so that we can obtain EBIT. So again, fixed cost is not known to us, but EBIT again we have calculated at the rupees 20 lakh. We can write it again 20 lakh as EBIT. Again, we are knowing contribution and EBIT. Definitely on this basis we can calculate fixed cost 40 lakh minus 20 lakh. That was our EBIT. Hence our fixed cost would again would be 20 lakh. Then minus interest. Interest is already been provided in the question at rupees 10 lakh. We would deduct interest so that we can obtain our EBT, that is earning before taxes. That is rupees 10 lakh. Again, as the taxation value is given, we can write it again tax at the rate 50% of our EBT, that is 10 lakh into 50%, that is our tax 5 lakh. we would deduct it and we get our EAT, that is earning after taxes. EAT, earnings after taxes. That is the factor what we are going to calculate. Just a quick reminder, first of all we will use financial leverage. We would use the standard formula which we were using earlier, EBIT divided by EBT. We have expanded the, what we can say, formula of EBT here. EBT is equals to EBIT minus interest. We have wrote it here. EBT is equals to EBIT minus interest. Why we have used this formula? Because apart from financial leverage, all these two variables were not known to us. By using this formula, at least one variable was given in the question which we can use to calculate EBIT. Hence, we have put the values 2 is to 1 is equals to EBIT divided by EBIT minus interest, that was 10 lakh. We have simplified and we get our EBIT. Then we have used the formula of operating leverage, contribution divided by EBIT. Operating leverage was provided in the question. EBIT we have calculated in the earlier part. Hence, we can easily find out our contribution. Third thing we need to calculate was of sales. For that information was given related to variable expenses is equals to 60% of sales. But what is sales? Sales is equals to variable cost plus contribution. We can understand it here more specifically. What we have calculated sales, that was 1 crore. 1 crore, remember, if suppose we don't have this value, variable cost 60 lakh plus contribution 40 lakh, 60 plus 40, 100. That is what we have written here in the according to the formula. Sales is equals to variable expenses plus contribution, that is variable expenses plus contribution 60 plus 40. What was our variable expenses? 60%. That means that remaining part is the contribution, that is 40%. 100% is equals to 60% plus 40%. Therefore, now we are not knowing sales, so we can not calculate that part. Hence, what we have done at 40% level, what was contribution? 40 lakh. 40 lakh. Therefore, at 100%, we are not knowing it. Therefore, what we have done? 40 lakh into 100 divided by 40. We get our answer as 1 crore. Now, we have all the items from which we can prepare our statement of income. We have sales, we have put the value. We have contribution, we have put the value. We have EBIT, we have put the value. Interest, we have put the value. Now, we have sales and contribution. We have deducted contribution from sales. We get our variable cost. Then, we have deducted EBIT from contribution. We can get our fixed cost. Then, interest was already provided, already been provided. Definitely, by deducting interest, we get EBIT. Then, we have calculated tax and gave our EAT. This was for this question. Try to practice this question specifically as they are important from the point of view of examination. Till then, thank you. Stay tuned.